Yes, good morning student. Today we will continue our chapter 5 algebraic expressions and special product. Now today we will discuss new concept for you, how to divide the polynomials by polynomial. Till now we discussed the division or divided polynomial by monomial, but today it is a totally new concept, so try to understand properly and see the steps properly. See here, divide first is example, we take divide this one polynomial by this one. It means we write down x minus 4 here, it is divisor. 2x square minus 11x plus 12, this is called dividend, and this one called divisor. When you divide it, you will got quotient, and if it is completely divisible, then okay, otherwise anything remaining, then it is called remainder. So now see, what is the process to solve this one question? X minus 4, 2x square minus 11x plus 12. Firstly, we will check that what is the first term of dividend. First term of dividend is 2x square, and the first term of divisor is x, then 2x square divide by x. If you see 2, x power 2, here x power 1, then when you take upside, then it become 2 minus 1, 1. So it means it is equal to 2x. Then you write down this 2x in the quotient first term. This is the first term of the quotient. Second step is what? This 2x now multiply by x minus 4. Is 2x ko hume is x minus 4 se multiply kar. कैसे करेंगे? 2x into x, 2x square, this sign is minus, 2 4 is 8x, we will got 8, 2x square minus 8x. Now put these terms below this. In division, you know what we will do next? Subtraction. In subtraction, you know that in the below terms we will change the sign. This is nothing here, it means positive then negative, negative then change into positive. Now see, this is plus 2x square, this is minus 2x square, it means it is cancel out. This is minus 11x, this is plus 8x, means minus 11x plus 8x is equal to plus minus minus, it means 11x minus 8x, but sign we take minus, so 11 minus 8, 3, so it become minus 3x, and we take this next term here, plus 12. Again see what we done in step first, the first term of dividend divide by first term of divisor, then we get this 2x, this is the first term of quotient. Now this first term of quotient multiply by x minus 4, x minus 4, then you got it, then you put here below, just below of this, solve it, do the subtraction. Now third method, step third, we can say subtraction, subtract and bring down 12. Firstly do subtraction, and then this last term we will take here. Now the next step is what? Step 4. Now your dividend, this first term is minus 3x and this first term is x, then if you got, then you got minus 3, it means this minus 3 are second term of quotient. Now the next step same, this minus 3 multiply by x minus 4, माइनस थ्री इंटू एक्स माइनस थ्री एक्स माइनस माइनस प्लस थ्री फोर ज़ा 12. इट मीन्स हेयर यू गॉट माइनस थ्री एक्स प्लस 12. नाउ सब्ट्रैक्शन, दिस माइनस चेंज इनटू प्लस, प्लस चेंज इनटू माइनस. माइनस थ्री एक्स प्लस थ्री एक्स कैंसिल आउट, प्लस 12 माइनस 12 कैंसिल आउट. इट मीन्स योर रिमाइंडर इज इक्वल टू 0. दिस इज कम्प्लीटली डिविजिबल. सो दिस टाइप वी विल सॉल्व. दिस इज अगेन आई एम सेइंग डिविजर. दिस वैल्यू नाउ डिविडेंड, दिस वन कोशियन, एंड यू डिडेंट गेट एनीथिंग हेयर. इट मीन्स रिमाइंडर इज इक्वल टू 0. So this type we will do divide polynomial by polynomial. We will take more example for understanding. See next example. Divide x cube minus x plus 19x square minus 29 by 2x plus 3. One more thing see here in this question. Firstly, our polynomial should be in standard form. Whenever we solve the problem, then our polynomial should be in standard form. Should be in standard form, it means change into the standard form. We can try to take in decreasing order. So, highest power is 6x power 3. Then plus 19x square, then minus x minus 29. Here already in decreasing order, we can write down this by 2x plus 3. Now see how to write down 2x plus 3 here, and then 6x power 3 plus 19x square minus x minus 29. Now see here. First term of this dividend 6x power 3. Your step first 6x power 3, and this first term is 2x. 2 3 is a 6. X power 3 or yahan 1 hai, so it means 3 minus 1 x power 2. So our first term of our quotient become 3x power 2. Step second, 3x square multiply by 2x plus 3. 3 2 is a 6, x power 2, 2 plus 1, 3 plus 3 3 is a 9, x power 2. Put this thing here, 6x power 3 plus 9x square. What is the next step? Do subtraction or change the sign of this, minus plus minus. Then 6x cube minus 6x cube cancel out, plus 19 minus 9, plus 19. See, both terms should be the same. Agar ye same nahi hai toh, so we can't solve it. Like terms only we can do addition and subtraction. So 19 minus 9, that is equal to 10x square. Then other terms we write down directly, minus x minus 29. Now the next step, this is 10x square. Again divided by 2x. 2 5s are 10. X power 2, 1. 2 minus 1, 1. 5x. It means, or it is plus 5x. It means here will come plus 5x. Next step, 5x multiply by 2x plus 3. 5 2s are 10, x power 2 plus 5 3s are 15x. Put here 10x square plus 15x. Next step, do subtraction. प्लस साइन चेंज माइनस नथिंग हियर वन माइनस वन माइनस फिफ्टीन माइनस माइनस प्लस सो वन प्लस फिफ्टीन बट बोथ आर नेगेटिव सो आंसर विल कम इन नेगेटिव सो इट विल बिकम माइनस सिक्सटीन एक्स माइनस नाइनटीन. अगेन वी हैव टू सॉल्व इट. दिस इज माइनस सिक्सटीन एक्स तो नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज व्हाट. माइनस सिक्सटीन एक्स डिवाइड बाय टू एक्स. दिस माइनस साइन कम हियर एक्स टू एक्स कैंसिल टू एट्स अ सिक्सटीन. इट मीन्स नेक्स्ट टर्म विल कम हियर माइनस आई एम राइटिंग हियर थ्री एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस फाइव एक्स माइनस एट. नाउ माइनस एट मल्टीप्लाई बाय टू एक्स प्लस थ्री दैट इज माइनस सिक्सटीन एक्स माइनस प्लस माइनस एट थ्री ज़ा ट्वेंटी फोर. सो दिस राइट डाउन माइनस सिक्सटीन एक्स माइनस ट्वेंटी फोर प्लस दिस ऑल्सो प्लस कैंसिल आउट. माइनस ट्वेंटी नाइन प्लस ट्वेंटी फोर प्लस माइनस माइनस बट ग्रेटर वैल्यू इज ट्वेंटी नाइन एंड हैज नेगेटिव साइन सो आंसर इज माइनस फाइव. सी नाउ हेयर नॉट एनी वेरिएबल. यहाँ इसकी डिग्री क्या है. डिग्री ऑफ दिस पॉलिनोमियल इज वन बिकॉज टू एक्स पावर वन. डिग्री ऑफ दिस पॉलिनोमियल इज जीरो बिकॉज दिस इज कॉन्स्टेंट. कॉन्स्टेंट पॉलिनोमियल डिग्री जीरो इज इक्वल टू जीरो एंड लीनियर पॉलिनोमियल डिग्री वन. तो अगर हमारे यहाँ डिग्री डिग्री ऑफ डिविजर से कम आ जाती है देन वी विल स्टॉप हियर. इट मीन्स दिस वैल्यू बिकम रिमाइंडर नो फर्दर डिविजन वी कैन डू हियर. ऑब्वियसली माइनस फाइव अपॉन टू एक्स वी कान डू. डिग्री ऑफ दिस थिंग शुड बी लेस देन फ्रॉम दिस. इट मीन्स रिमाइंडर की डिग्री पॉलिनोमियल डिविजर की डिग्री से हमेशा क्या होती है कम होती है. दिस थिंग दिस टाइप वी डू. नाउ इफ वी वॉन्ट टू चेक दैट आवर डिविजन इज करेक्ट और नॉट देयर इज वन फॉर्मूला लाइक दिस दैट डिविडेंड इज इक्वल टू डिविजर मल्टीप्लाई बाय क्वोशन प्लस रिमाइंडर. डिविडेंड इक्वल होता है डिविजर मल्टीप्लाई बाय कोशियंट प्लस रिमाइंडर के. चेक कर लेते हैं. हमारा डिविडेंड हमें पता है. डिविजर हमारे पास है 2x प्लस 3. कोशियंट हमारे पास है 3x स्क्वायर प्लस 5x माइनस 8. रिमाइंडर हमारे पास है माइनस 5. इसको सॉल्व करना हम सीख चुके हैं. 2x फर्स्टली मल्टीप्लाई बाय 3x square plus 5x minus 8 or remove it. See here 2x multiply by 3x square plus 5x minus 8. Then next is plus 3. 3x square plus 5x minus 8 minus 5. बाइनोमियल को पॉलिनोमियल से मल्टीप्लाई करना है. देर आर टू टर्म्स. सो फर्स्टली 2x मल्टीप्लाई बाय होल देन प्लस 3 मल्टीप्लाई बाय होल. नाउ सी 2 3 ज़ा 6 एक्स पावर 1 और 2 3 प्लस 2 5 ज़ा 10 एक्स पावर 1 और 1 2 माइनस 8 2 ज़ा 16x प्लस 3 3 ज़ा 9x स्क्वायर प्लस 3 5 ज़ा 15x प्लस माइनस माइनस 24 माइनस 5. नाउ सॉल्व इट. एनी लाइक टर्म हियर 6x पावर 3 नो लाइक टर्म 10x स्क्वायर प्लस 9x स्क्वायर 10 प्लस 9 19x स्क्वायर माइनस 16x प्लस 15x तो माइनस 16 प्लस 15 इज इक्वल टू माइनस 1 दैट इज माइनस x. minus 24 minus 5 minus 29. If you see properly, 6x cube 19x square minus x minus 29. This type we will get our result. It means what is the procedure? Dividend is equal to divisor multiply by quotient plus remainder. If remainder is zero, अगर हम ये कह देते हैं कि इन द फर्स्ट कंडीशन कि इन द फर्स्ट कंडीशन जैसे हमने किया था 2x क्यूब माइनस 11x प्लस 12 डिवाइड किया था x माइनस 4 डिवाइडेड बाय दिस. इन दिस केस रिमाइंडर इज जीरो, कंप्लीटली डिविजिबल है. इट मीन्स ये डिविडेंड इस डिविजर से कंप्लीटली डिविजिबल है. तो वी कैन से वन मोर थिंग दैट एक्स माइनस फोर इज ए फैक्टर ऑफ 2x क्यूब माइनस 11x प्लस 12. वी कैन से x minus 4 is a factor of 2x cube minus 11x plus 12. It means अगर ये इससे completely divisible है, तो ये जो divisor है, divisor is the factor of the given polynomial. Dividend का factor है. Okay, now see one more example we will take. Now your question is using division show that x square plus 2 minus 3x is a factor of 2 minus 3x square plus x minus x cube plus x power 4. Using division means हमें division करना है और उसके बाद ये show करना है कि this one polynomial is a factor of this polynomial. It means for us this is divisor and this one is dividend. But if you see properly both of these not in a standard form. It means firstly we will change into standard form. So see here, in standard form this one become x square plus 3x minus 2 and this will in standard form highest power x power 4 and this one is positive, then minus x power 3, then minus 3x square plus x plus again see x power 4 has positive sign, minus x power 3 minus 3x square plus x plus 2. Now see same thing, firstly we divide x power 2 4 divided by x power 2, then you got 4 minus 2 x power 2. It means our quotient first term become x power 2. Secondly, we do x power 2 multiply by x power 2 plus 3x minus 2. X power 2 into 2, 4. This is 1, 1 into 3, 3, 2 or into 1. Then x power 3 minus 2x square. Put here, x power 4 plus 3x power 3 minus 2x square. Do subtraction, minus, minus, plus. Cancel out. Always we try to do first term cancel out. There always one term should be positive, then next term should be negative. See here now. Minus, nothing is here, it means 1. Minus 1 minus 3. Minus 4. But x power 3. Minus 3 plus 2. Minus 1 There is no need to write down minus 1, so we write down minus x square. So you can write down this also. Now take these terms. Next step. Now your term become minus 4x power 3 and this one is x power 2. Then it become minus 4, 3 minus 2, 1, then x power 1. So here next term is minus 4x. Now multiply. Minus 4x multiply by x square plus 3x minus 2 minus 4x power 3 minus plus minus 4 3 is a 12 x power 2 minus minus plus 4 2 is a 8x. So we write down minus 4x power 3 minus 12x square plus 8x. Change the sign, plus plus minus, cancel out. Minus 1 and plus 12. Minus 1 plus 12, obviously 11. Plus x 1 minus 8. Minus 7x plus 2. Now next, 11x square, or this is x square. So next step is what? 11x square upon x square, that is equal to 11. Plus 11, so do multiply. 11x square plus plus 11 3 is a 33x plus minus minus 22. Now do change the sign, cancel out. Minus 7 minus 33, it means minus 40x plus 2 plus 22, 24. Now see, degree of this polynomial 2, degree of this polynomial 1. So degree of this is less than from this, it means it becomes remainder. So what is our question? Wait. Okay, here I solved according to this. There is some mistake. X square minus 2 plus 3x. Okay, what is this? What is the means of this question? If we are getting remainder, it means this is not a factor of this given polynomial. Or if we are not getting remainder, suppose this question now I solve like this. X square plus 2 minus 3x. Now do again. X square plus 2 minus 3x. It means here come minus, here come plus. First step will be the same. X square, that become x power 4 minus 3x power 3 plus 2x square. And when you subtract it, minus 1 plus 3 become 2x power 3 minus 3 minus 2 minus 5x square plus x plus 2. Now see, next term is 2x power 3 upon x square, then it become 2x. So here plus 2x, 2x multiply by this 2x power 3 plus minus, or you can do right like this also, 2x into x, 2x square minus 2 3 is a 6x square plus 4x minus 6x square plus 4x minus plus minus, cancel out. Minus 5 plus 6 plus 1, then x square plus 1 minus 4 minus 3x plus 2. Now x square upon x square become 1, then we will do plus 1 x square minus 3x plus 2 minus plus minus, cancel out, cancel out, cancel out. Remainder 0. So in this case, if we get remainder 0, it means we can say that this is a factor of this given polynomial. this is the question for this. In this case, when you take this situation, you get some remainder, it means then it is not a factor of given polynomial. So it depends totally on the remainder. Whenever we performing the division procedure, then it depends on the remainder. If we get remainder value 0, it means divisor is the factor of the dividend. Or if we didn't get the remainder 0, it means divisor is not a factor of the dividend. So we will solve more problems based on this in our next lecture. So try to solve. This is your totally new concept for you, and try to solve more and more problems based on it. Thank you, students.